So the first one, 4n squared minus 300n plus 12, is contained in O of n squared because n squared is the fastest growing term. So it's correct. And it's also the best possible bound because we have n squared here as the fastest growing term, which is exactly the same that we wrote here. The second one is also correct because n to the power of 3 grows faster than n squared, but it's not the best possible bound we can give because we already found out that n squared is the best possible bound that we can give. Now down here, 3 to the power of n plus 5n squared minus 3n grows much faster than n squared. So this is not true. And of course, it cannot be the best possible bound if it's not a correct bound at all. In the next one, 3 to the power of n is the fastest growing term. And this is exactly what we're stating on the right here. So it's correct. And it's also the best possible bound that we can give. The next one, again, the bound is correct. This is similar to here when we compared n to the power of 3 to n squared. So 4 to the power of n grows much faster than 3 to the power of n. But again, it's not the best possible bound because we already know that 3 to the n is the best possible bound that we can give. This one down here is similar to one of the examples that I just showed you. So we can ignore the constant here. And 2 to the power of n times n squared grows faster than 2 to the power of n. So this is not correct. And since it's not correct, it cannot be the best possible bound. Now, this one down here is probably a little bit tricky because 2.1 to the power of n indeed grows faster than 2 to the power of n times n squared. So if you plot those two functions, you can see that 2.1 to the power of n will outgrow this part here, 2 to the power of n times n squared. So it is a correct bound, but it is not the best possible one because the best possible one would be 2 to the power of n times n squared and not 2.1 to the power of n, which grows much faster. So as you can see, O notation is simply about looking at which part of a function grows the fastest, and then it's a very convenient way of actually describing the growth of that function while ignoring details that are a bit distracting and not necessary for the analysis that we're going to do in this course. Now there's one final note I should make. Some people, instead of writing f of n is contained in O of g of n, also write f of n is equal to O of g of n. And sometimes, but this is not very common, people will also write it as if it were a subset. So they would use this symbol here and say it's a subset contained in O of g of n. This here is probably the most correct way to state it, because O of g of n is actually a set of functions if you were to consider it mathematically. But this one up here equals O of g of n is also a very common one that you can also find in many scientific papers and even teaching books.